General David Muhoozi, the Minister of State for Internal Affairs, led officials from the Ministry of Uganda Police Force to Parliament's Defence and Internal Affairs Committee, which was recently directed by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, to investigate alleged fraudulent operations in the Exodus Circle. This followed reports from police officers who complained about compulsory monthly savings, challenges in accessing their savings, lack of representation of lower cadres at the annual general meetings, among others.
Of voluntary membership? Is it voluntary or it is forceful? That one, maybe we need also clarification on it. We also need clarification on... You talked about it. But accessing money by the deceased relatives, yet you've talked about the Administrator General's office, those meetings. Don't you have a policy that you have, like capturing the next of kin with the biodata? Because that one helped us here in this circle of parliament, where you have in the next of kin with his biodata, the photo, and everything.
There are complaints that people are forced. Because no. If you go to my station in Buwenge, I was there the other day. I interested myself to know the members of the circle, and they are not there. So who are the delegates that are from there?
The circle board chairman, Dr. Wilson Omoding, submitted that some police officers on the management of the Exodus Circle have been suspended, while others are being investigated for misusing savers' money.
Somebody gets a loan and picks it and he goes to blow it. And that is the biggest problem that our officers are grappling with. You find, depending on the behavior of a person, you can invest anywhere and money is blown without seeing the results of that loan. But we have taken them, guiding them on where to invest and what should be invested in.
In 2020, the 8th Annual General Meeting of the Circle resolved that each officer of a junior rank and senior rank makes a minimum saving contribution of 30,000 shillings and 50,000 shillings, respectively, per month in order to enhance society's capacity to provide affordable credit. The meeting also resolved that members access part of their savings twice a year.
You find the stories of people who have acquired the loans, people don't want to talk about them, but there are only few who want to talk about it. But a number of benefited. So that is what we are working on, to make sure that every member of the force must feel that this circle is part of them. They must work towards it, improving it, so that we forget the past. You know, what is still haunting officers is the previous.
General Muhoozi emphasized to the committee that the restriction of access to savings in the circle was informed by issues of liquidity and not any other ulterior motives.
This is the decision of the AGM, and I think also it was informed by issues of liquidity, because if you save as you take, then there's an issue. So I need to point out that issue, that one, it's a decision of the AGM. They decided that way because you can't have access unregulated. I think that one we should agree. That you put, you take.
The Deputy Inspector General of Police, Major General Geoffrey Katsigazi, also explained that membership of the Exodus Circle is voluntary, contrary to complaints by a section of police officers that they are forced to join the cooperative.
Membership is voluntary. There is no force at all. There is encouragement to save, encouragement to join this circle. But as you can see, not all police officers are members of Exodus.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.